Honorable Speaker, Andhra Pradesh State Legislative Assembly, Honorable Members of the State Legislature, I am immensely pleased to welcome and congratulate the newly elected Honorable Members of the State Legislative Assembly and Members of the Legislative Council to this joint session of the State Legislature being convened for the first time after the general elections 2024. I would like to take this opportunity to commend the Andhra people's active participation in the electoral process. Their inspiration for change has been unambiguous. Now the responsibility of fulfilling their aspirations lies with all of you. Honorable members, you are aware that due to the supreme sacrifice of Amarajivi Potti Sri Ramulu, Andhra Pradesh was formed as the first linguistic state on 1st October 1953 with Kurnool as capital. Thereafter, the state was recognized on 1st November 1956 and Telugu-speaking parts of Hyderabad state were made into the combined Andhra Pradesh with Hyderabad as capital. Accordingly, a lot of Telugu people moved to Hyderabad. Again, in June 2014, the people of Andhra Pradesh were forced to undergo another reorganization of their state, the most damaging experience of all. The united Andhra Pradesh was bifurcated unscientifically, undemocratically, and without adequate members of the state legislature. I am immensely pleased to welcome and congratulate the newly elected Honorable Members of the State Legislative Assembly and Members of the Legislative Council to this joint session of the State Legislature being convened for the first time after the general elections 2024. I would like to take this opportunity to commend the Andhra people's active participation in the electoral process. Their inspiration for change has been unambiguous. Now the responsibility of fulfilling their aspirations lies with all of you. Honorable members, you are aware that due to the supreme sacrifice of Amarajivi Potti Sri Ramulu, Andhra Pradesh was formed as the first linguistic state on 1st October 1953 with Kurnool as capital. Thereafter, the state was recognized on 1st November 1956 and Telugu-speaking parts of Hyderabad state were made into the combined Andhra Pradesh with Hyderabad as capital. Accordingly, a lot of Telugu people moved to Hyderabad. Again, in June 2014, the people of Andhra Pradesh were forced to undergo another reorganization of their state, the most damaging experience of all. The united Andhra Pradesh was bifurcated unscientifically, undemocratically, and without adequate consultation with the stakeholders. This has left an indelible mark on the minds of the people of the residual state of Andhra Pradesh. The turbulence caused due to multiple state reorganizations and the resultant disruptions have deprived Andhra people of a sustained long period development and progress. Today we stand at a juncture where the people have to again take up the task of rebuilding their state. As time has progressed, it has become evident that the Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Act 2014 does not compensate enough the residual Andhra Pradesh for the loss of prosperity and development opportunities. The state bifurcation has imposed an unprecedented strain on the economy of the state. There are patent inconsistencies in distribution of assets and liabilities, with 58.32% of combined state population. The unscientific bifurcation caused the state to inherit only 46% of the resources. Financial loss on account of loss of Hyderabad city, disproportionate debt burden, loss of access to public institutions, loss of national institutions, Government of India, PSUs, and institutions of higher learning, etc. One can see that scientific criteria for apportionment were not adopted, while the residual state inherited huge revenue deficit. Debt was shared on population basis, assets on location basis, power sharing on consumption basis, and worst of all, educational institutions with no basis. All these factors led to the structural change in economy, with reduction of service sectors from 51% to 44%. The per capita income too fell from 1,06,176 for the combined state to ₹93,121 for AP. Notwithstanding the adverse impact of the state bifurcation and undaunted by challenges such as budgetary constraints, infrastructural deficiencies, and unresolved issues, the government converted every crisis into an opportunity during the period 2014 to 19. The government had laid a solid foundation for a vibrant sunrise Andhra Pradesh. The then government focused on the inherent strengths of the successor state of Andhra Pradesh, its 974 kilometer coastline, providing opportunities for full-fledged development and requisite environment for manufacturing activities. The fertile river plains supporting agriculture and allied activities, the passing of three industrial corridors through the state, the rich natural and human resources. A reflection on the state's performance during the 5-year period of 2014 to 19 gives a clear picture of the balancing act between development and welfare. Completion of prestigious Pattaseema project by linking of rivers Godavari and Krishna in a short time of 1 year. Completion of 72% of Polavaram project so that it could be made fully operational by 2021. Prioritization of other irrigation projects, drought-proofing measures, real-time governance, development of Amaravati region through land pooling, construction of new secretariat and legislature building are a few examples worthy of mention. All the milestones achieved during 2014 to 19 were possible because of the visionary leadership of Sri Nara Chandrababu Naidu, the Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh. In this regime, the state attracted marquee FDAs like Kia Motors, emerging as number one state continuously in ease of doing business rankings. Under his able leadership, the state attracted several investments in various sectors. The government initiated development of Kakinada SEZ port, Bhavanapadu and Ramayapatnam ports, expanded airports and increased the state road network. The development of infrastructure was balanced with welfare measures such as increase in old age pension, farm loan waiver, scholarships to students, construction of houses, etc. These development and welfare measures led to compound annual growth of 13.5% between 2014 to 2019. While the state was set to take off on the path of high growth, the change of regime in 2019 again brought back the disturbing time for the nascent Andhra Pradesh. The state that already bore print of bifurcation in 2014 was rather unfortunate to have witnessed yet another bigger debacle in the form of inept governance, where the people were threatened and officers demoralized. In fact, the damage and losses during the period 2019 to 24 have been more severe compared to the state reorganization in June 2014. The government that assumed charge in 2019 started a destructive note with demolition of Praja Vedike that continued unabated till the end of the regime 2024. During this regime, democracy was at peril. People were in a state of fear and hardly enjoyed any freedom of living. The regime revenge politics had severely hampered the state's prospects for prosperity and growth. Even the Honorable High Court of Andhra Pradesh had sought to convene a judicial inquiry into whether there is a constitutional breakdown in the state. The biggest damage was done to the brand AP. No noteworthy companies came forward to invest in the state. The corrupt practices at all levels, coupled with weaponization of instruments of governance across revenue earning departments for personal gains, sabotaging of checks and balances, made several state institutions and private companies defunct and forced the existing enthusiastic investors and entrepreneurs to move out of Andhra Pradesh to other states. The uncertain environment, which rocked the confidence of the people in general and investors in particular, started showing impact on the state finances, leaving them in a mess. Fiscal prudence was abandoned. Expenditure was beyond means in spite of limited revenue growth, and debt and liabilities rose sharply. Financial management is manifested by diversion of funds, higher taxation despite high inflation, increase in power sector liabilities, neglect of capital expenditure, which eventually resulted in slowing down of the economy. The enormous gap in resources was sought to be met repeatedly by borrowings through corporations and forcing them to spend on government expenditure, and in the process weakening the corporations. In view of the inordinate delay in clearance of the bills due to strained financial position of the state, many vendors and contractors have approached the High Court of Andhra Pradesh for relief and filed cases against the government. About 25,000 cases have been filed for bill payments, which is unprecedented. The sheer number of contempt cases with personal appearances and arrest warrants against officials in several cases resulted in systematic humiliation and victimization of bureaucracy. This led to complete demoralization of administrative machinery. The capital expenditure reduced by 60% in 2019-24 compared to 2014-19. Departments such as water resources and transport, roads and buildings, which undertake substantial capital works, were left critically short of funds to carry out any works. The capital expenditure on water resources has reduced by 56%, and that on roads and buildings by an alarming 85% during this period. The compound annual growth rate of state's own tax revenue slipped from 12.8% to 8.1% during this period. On the other hand, the revenue expenditure increased from 7.8% to 10.5%, whereas the capital expenditure growth declined steeply from 26.4% to 3.4%. Lower share of capital expenditure to public debt occurred during the period 2019 to 24 is a clear indicator that the government met revenue expenditure also through borrowed funds. The CAGR in per capita debt has been higher at 14%, while the CAGR in per capita income is only